Gusto ko po sanang tanungin, government official from the previous administration of DepEd, the time of the previous secretary, in 2023 po ba, ano po ba ang ratio natin ng teacher to computer set at ng estudyante to computer set? Madam Chair?
Sino bang in charge ng computers? Admit? Maybe our director for, because the previous undersecretary for admin has resigned, Your Honor. But there, we have with us the director for IT, that's Director Pitagan. Maybe we could ask that he be recognized to explain and answer the question. With your permission, Madam Chair.
Director Pitagan, you're recognized.
Blessed morning to all. Ma'am, for the student ratio, currently we are one computer per...
If I may interrupt, we are asking for the year 2023, sir, so we can relate it with the result of the AOM for 2023.
Ma'am, for the 2023 fund, ma'am, the computer ratio is 1:9, meaning one computer, 9 students po.
That is 1:9. One computer for 9 students. How about the ratio for the teachers?
Ma'am, for the teachers, come on, we're getting the, ma'am, the grand total, dito po yung region is, one computer is for 30 teachers.
One computer for 30 teachers.
30.57.
That is almost saying impossible to facilitate an e-learning system having one computer for 30 teachers. And I believe, Madam Chair, that this validates the reason why the DepEd in 2023 requested and lobbied for an allocation amounting to 11,361,000,000. In other words, sinuportahan po tayo ng Senado at ng Kongreso in addressing this need, in addressing this gap. However, if I may request the Secretary to flash the next slide. If I may invite your attention to the current appropriations. Ito po yung appropriation for 2023. The amount is 11,361,000,000. However, ang naging utilization po niya is only 19.22%. That is equivalent by way of obligation to 2,183,000,000 and disbursement to 2,075,000,000. So, bakit po sa tindi ng pangangailangan natin for ICT packages? Madam Chair, out of 11 billion allocation, bakit po 2,075,000,000 lang ang naging disbursement? Can we hear from DepEd?
Please answer the question. May we direct the Director Pitagan to answer, please.
Thank you very much, sir. Ma'am, for the 2023, when the new administration came in, the priority was the continuing 2022. That's why for 2022 funds, we have the 92% obligation. Now, yung 2023, ma'am, tumawid ngayon siya na 2024. So right
Madam
now...
Madam Chair, if I may interrupt,
opo.
Parang ang hirap pong i-appreciate nung naging explanation nyo na ang priority nyo is continuing, which is the budget from 2022. Why therefore did you request for 11 billion for 2023? Kung sasabihin nyo ngayon, ang priority nyo is 2022, kaya hindi nyo nagamit yung 2023. Alam po ninyo, Mr. Resource Speaker, dun po sa amin sa Batangas, hindi po magkamayaw ang humihingi ng tulong na estudyante, teacher, and even PTA officers. Lahat ang problema nila computer, laptop. Now we have this 11 billion budget. You requested this for 2023. Bakit po ang disbursement nyo 2 billion lang?
Yun, ma'am. To answer the question po, in May 2024, nabili na po natin yung 2023 budget. Ang pending po natin, 95% na yung ating obligation. Kaya lang po hindi po nagre-reflect is because we are asking for the modification of the expense class from capital outlay to MOOE.
Madam Chair, yun po bang May 2024 na sinasabi nyo? Does this pertain to the 2 billion disbursement?
Hindi, ma'am. This pertains to the 8 billion more na hindi pa na gagamit.
So, nasaan po yung 8 billion?
Ma'am, yun, nagamit na po natin to.
Where are the computer sets now?
The computers now are being delivered to the schools. Yung pong hinahanap nyo na 20...
Who can validate that information that they are being delivered to schools? Because as far as I know, napakatindi po ng pangangailangan for computers ng ating mga public schools. If I may continue, Madam Chair, he made mention about the continuing appropriation. So let me invite your attention to color blue of the slide. Ayan po yung continuing appropriation. We have 9 billion budget. Tama po si Mr. Resource Speaker. May nagamit na 8 billion. But what surprises me a lot, punta po tayo sa baba. Both the current and the continuing has an accomplishment of 0%. Does our resource speaker validate this report? This is as of December 31, 2023.
Yes, ma'am.
And if I may add, Madam Chair, pagdating po natin dito sa accomplishment report, I hope the people of Batangas are listening to me para hindi na nila kulitin kung nasan itong mga computer. We're talking about 2,349 LC, 2,648 smart TVs, 12,022 laptops, 7,558 laptops. That is for current appropriation. And for continuing appropriation, Madam Chair, ang hindi po nade-deliver, 6,770 packages. And the breakdown is 4,067 LC, 337 smart TVs, and 2,366 laptops with 3,161 laptops for non-teaching personnel. This is as of December 31, 2023. Nasaan po itong mga equipments na ito?
Madam Chair, Your Honor, yung pong pinabagit nyo na 4,067 laptops, na-deliver na po natin ang 91.47%. Yung pong sinabanggit nyo na 337 packages ng smart TVs, na-deliver na po natin ang 91.6%. Doon po sa laptop for teaching na 2,366 packages, 100% na po na na-deliver natin to para sa mga teachers. At yung pong laptops for non-teaching, na-deliver na rin po ito ng 100%. These are all accounted for the fund year of 2022.
May we request the resource speaker to submit to us the documents proving all the delivery?
Yes, ma'am.
And can we go, Mr. Resource Speaker, to the current appropriation? Nasaan po itong 17,019 packages under the current appropriation?
Okay. Ma'am, under the current appropriation for the e-learning carts, that's 1,655 packages. Medyo mababa pa po yung ating delivery dito, which is 3.44 delivery because the contract, ma'am, the NTP was May to December. So ang target po before the end of the year, maibigay po yung lahat ng ELC. Sa STV naman, ma'am, It's the same for 5,942 packages. It's 3.77% na po yung na-deliver.
If I may interrupt, Madam Chair, in other words, the average percentage with respect to the delivery is 3%.
Yes, ma'am.
Out of the total number of packages.
Yes, ma'am. Because the procurement of the current 2024 happened in January.
Madam Chair, I hope that the DepEd, Mr. Resource Speaker, realizes that the specification when we talk about ICT changed so fast. Hindi ko po alam kung paano nyo i-realize ito concerning the possible significant changes already with the specs of the ICT packages for which the current appropriation is originally allocated.
Thank you very much for that very good observation. Ma'am, all our packages from e-learning card to STV, laptop for teachers and laptop for non-teaching are duly vetted and cleared from the Department of Information, Communication, and Technology. So nagsasubmit po kami sa kanila ng tech specs, including that of the 2023, and they gave us the corresponding clearance.
What causes the delay?
Ma'am, yung...
Or should I say, who causes the delay?
Ma'am, hindi naman. Ma'am, kasi yun nga pong 2024, yung current fund. Siyempre po, nagsimula po kami ng procurement ng January.
No, so, this is 2023 budget.
Ah, the 2023 budget.
Ma'am, current appropriation pertains to 2023 current appropriation.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, yun nga po, if I may backtrack a bit, kasi po noong 2023, when we first came in, yung new breed of leaders, hindi pa po nagagalaw yung 2022. So naging priority po muna yon noong 2023.
I will go back to my question, Madam Chair. If your priority is 2022, then you should not have requested for 2023. Kanina po may nabanggit na nasa warehouse. Ano po ba yung nasa warehouse?
Ma'am, yung nasa warehouses na nabanggit, these are not these lots. Ito pong DepEd computerization program na ito, ito po yung recalibrated DCP. Yung pong nasa warehouse, those are those purchased during 2020-2021.
Yes, ma'am. Ito pong 2022, ito yung 2023, ito po yung dinideliver pa lang ngayong 2024.
Yes, ma'am.
Madam Chair, I just wish to manifest my frustration about the significant delay in the proper bidding, procurement, and delivery of all this ICT equipments. Ito po'y kailangan ng ating mga public schools. As a matter of fact, I wish to believe na ito po ang dahilan kung bakit ang Philippine education ay nasa bottom ng ranking ng PISA. Mayroon naman po tayong budget. Why don't we act promptly? So we address this problem in the Department of Education.
Yes, thank you very much, Your Honor, for that observation validating the need of technology for schools. Ma'am, kaya po ngayon, doon po sa hinihingi namin na 2025, we have started already the early procurement activities. Para po ngayon this year, meron na pong NEP level, sinimulan na po namin yung EPA activities para nga pagdating ng 2025, mabili ka agad.
Madam Chair, I wish to go back to my question. What caused the delay in the procurement for 2023? Because I do not consider as a valid excuse na priority nyo on 2022. Please give me a valid reason.
Well, yung some of the reasons na nilagay din po namin, number one, we have to, well, since bago yung leadership, we have to recalibrate. Kasi ma'am, dati e-classroom siyon. So we have to really do an extensive onboarding of all the strands, all the people on the ground. Ano ba talaga yung kailangan? Magbibigay ba tayo ng computer laboratory? And a whole other...
Ibig sabihin, Mr. Resource Speaker, while you are doing all this procurement, you have not made up your mind as to the specification of the ICT that you are procuring. That is a manifestation, Madam Chair. I acknowledge that my time ended already. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Representative Luis Roe.